I am humble. I'm not as arrogant, as cocksure as the Jews were in the time of Jesus. You have the privilege of being as arrogant as you like. I am humble. I believe in the grace of God, and on that strength. Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey, what's up everybody, welcome back to our channel. It's your boy Jesse Keegan and we are Fanny&jessy. So right about now we're gonna do another reaction videos. Before I get into the video guys, I want to thank everybody out there who've been subscribing to our channel. I want to thank the people who've been commenting on our comment section below. You guys are really amazing, man. Positive comments, such an amazing people. And if you're new to this channel, we are Fanny&jessy. My girlfriend is not here. We do a lot of reaction videos. Just let us know in the comment section below what you want us to do. We're gonna do it for you. Anything you feel like it's entertaining, it's educative, it's informative, just let us know in the comment section below and we're gonna do it for you. So and another important thing guys, we have our YouTube channel. We have our new YouTube channel called Fanny&jessy 2.0 where we post our daily vlogs. Just go in there and subscribe. The link is gonna be in the comments section. The first comment, we're gonna pin it. Just make sure to go and click that link. It will take you to our new channel. Make sure to subscribe and, you know, be part of the family, man. And thank you so much for taking your time. I mean, it's really amazing and it's really humble to see people taking their own time to come and watch our videos. You guys are just amazing. So right about now, what we're gonna do is that we're gonna react to Deedat at his best, part 18. People love Deedat so much and they said like we should react to this one. I mean, they love him so much. I mean, he's undebatable. He's somebody who has a good charisma, the wisdom is there, and he really knows what he does. Anyway guys, without any further ado, let's get it.
Hey, where are you going?
Mr. Deedat.
Yes.
Mike, by the grace of God, I believe that we'll go in heaven, inshallah.
But now, of God, transport a person to heaven.
You know, this cocksureness that you're displaying and the display of your fellow cultists there, you know, it amazes me that the Christian, they were dragging their feet to get to the mic in the first instance. It's one by one, you're getting the courage to come along and waste our time. You're making statements and you want an answer. I am humble. I'm not as arrogant, as cocksure as the Jews were in the time of Jesus. You have the privilege of being as arrogant as you like. I am humble. I believe in the grace of God, and on that strength, I have hope that by God willing, I shall enter the good pleasures of God. Did I condemn you? No, that is you condemning yourself. The way, the arrogant stand in which you are standing now, and your fellow Christians there in that corner, ready to run away, look at them. Is this the way, you know, cultured people and Christians behave? Look at this. Look at the behavior. It's an absolute disgrace on born-again Christians. Yes, my friend, if you have a question, please ask your question. Because we can suffer from hallucinations. You see, people thinking that they are on the right track, they are actually disobeying the laws and commandments of God. Instead of worshipping God, they're worshipping a created being, a creature born in the stable to a Jewish girl. Now you say, he is your God. So for that, we say that you are going to go to hell. There is no way out for you because you are now conferring divinity upon a human being, and this human being never claimed to be God. You see, this human being was born in the stable 2,000 years ago. In the stable, he was circumcised on the eighth day. He used to drink milk from his mother's breast. He used to wet his napkins. I don't know, but I can see you. Look, you have been agreeing with the speaker all along. I was watching you. You were agreeing all along. But somehow at the back of the mind, there is another type of, you know, cultivation, which is making you to think that you have got the right road, but you are my child on the wrong road. You see, Jesus Christ never said he's God. Nowhere. Nor did he say, worship me anywhere. So if you have a church, you know, if you have a church, your minister, your padre, your bishop, ask him to organize a meeting and we will come and listen to him. You see, on all these things that you're talking, and then we will question them. And I assure you, your bishop or your pope will get cold feet and he'll never allow anybody to question them. There are Christian missionaries here. They're going to deliver lectures, but they haven't got that courage of their conviction to allow the Muslims to question them. They want to push things down people's throats. Look, this we haven't done to you. We have given you a very fair opportunity, as you will acknowledge, but people have been dragging their feet to the mic. That you will also agree. Look, you should have been the first man. Look, people have been dragging their feet. So, look, you were there. People from the outside, they had been coming in, but it took you so long to come, you are the last man. May God bless you. But now, look, what you do, arrange a meeting, or a dialogue, or a discussion, or a debate. Go ahead and arrange it, and we will come and meet you on your ground.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately,
no time. Wow, wow. That's Deedat at his best, man. I mean, such an amazing person. I think we've covered a lot of this type of videos where Christians claim that Jesus is God, where Jesus didn't say anything that he is God and they should worship him. I think we've covered a lot of videos like this one. I think by now people should just understand, or maybe they should just I think it's upon the Christians to probably, not even the Christians, the leaders of Christians to maybe teach their followers what it really entails about talking about Jesus is God or something like that. I think it really starts with what? With the leaders, because I think there's a lot of misconception and stuff like that. Because it's I think sometimes people just want to make people believe, but again, people should get into the scripture and read the scripture and understand it. I think if you read and understand, that's where you get the knowledge, you get it. But don't let anybody just tell you something without you particularly going to do your own research. I mean, it's really important. If somebody tells you, like, you know that the grass does not grow without water, you understand, you'll be like, yeah. But again, I think it's much better for you to go and do a research to find out if the grass grows without water. You understand? Don't just accept and just listen and just, you know, close that window of, you know what, let me not go do a research about it. Somebody say that if you want to enslave people, just put it in a book. You understand? Because most of the people don't want to read. I mean, at this generation that we're in today, most of the people are, not most, but a number of people, like, don't want to read that much. They don't want to go into details. All they do is they're on their phones all the time, they're on social media. You understand? So they're like, we're being dumbed down to an extent that we are so vulnerable enough to just wait for somebody to come and tell us, so this is it, this is how it is. So, you know, anybody can come and change any information at a particular level, because you don't have the knowledge, because somebody's telling you this and you go to an action of just agreeing to that without even going and following it up or doing your own research and whatnot. I mean, people should go and do a lot of research about the Bible. And we've been doing a lot of these videos, and I feel that there's something wrong, but hopefully something's going to be fixed when it's not too late. Anyway, guys, if you feel like I reacted to this video in a better way, just give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to go down in the comment section, tell me exactly what you feel about my reaction. What do you feel about this video here of Deedat? Just let me know in the comment section what do you think. Just give me your thoughts and we can discuss. Anyway, and the most important thing is, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The more you keep on subscribing, the more you give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you better content. And last but not the least, I'm going to see you in the next video, and peace out.